What are your memories of The Omen before you took on the show? Were you really, like, into the movie or no?
I had only heard of it prior to auditioning for it, and then once I was in contention for the role, I watched The Omen as a 35-year-old.
I only remember the creepy governess. I remember her, and I remember who gets his head?
The captain, right?
Yeah.
What's his name?
David Conner.
But the character's name.
I can't remember.
I remember that.
Yeah.
As a kid. So I remember, I definitely have scary memories. And then I rewatched it. It's really good. And I love Gregory Peck.
Who doesn't?
Yes. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
It's on my bucket list was to be in something with Gregory Peck, and yep. We could check it off.
So how much backstory were you given to help you out with this? Like, do you know everything that's going on with your character?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, for my character, I basically I have creative license to kind of build that backstory because she's new. But I definitely had to research The Omen and
because I mean, you meet Damien on screen for the first time, whereas opposed to my character,
yeah,
he has known Damien for about a year and a half. So yeah, I mean, is that kind of like
yeah.
What you asked?
Yeah. Yeah.
To the extent, yeah, Glenn, you know, when we first got to Toronto to film, he sat us down for an hour and we talked about the character and kind of the background and where he sees the character and kind of like what we want as actors for our character, which is something really rare for an executive producer to do.
Mm-hmm. Really rare.
So it was very much a collaboration.
Have you guys tried to make the show appeal to non-horror fans as well, people who might not have seen the original?
I think it does. I think just the writing, I don't think it's really adheres to one genre. I think that's what's kind of cool about the show is it kind of traverses genres and can be appealing to lots of people.
Yeah, just like I felt like The Omen, as watching it as an adult, it didn't feel like just a horror movie to me. There was a sense of thriller to it. And I feel like that's kind of what our show does. So, you know, it's I think, yeah, if someone wants just horror, I don't know what they're going to find in our show.
Well, do you think, I mean, we've only seen 3 episodes now. Is he going to start to really question his best friend, or is this something he's just going to go along with, or can you drop any hints about that?
There comes a point in the season, yes, where it becomes obvious that this is not me. But he's yes. I don't know. I can't really talk about it.
Okay.
But there is a point, yes, where you can't deny it anymore.
Should we be worried about your characters? Because it seems like everybody Damien gets close to meets
Absolutely.
Terrible ends.
When I saw The Omen, I was like, crap, I'm not going to make it through the first season. Everyone's
I didn't think
fair
I didn't.
Game. What's that?
I mean, who knows if I do?
Yeah, exactly. Who knows? But yeah, I definitely didn't feel safe going into the series.
Well, can you talk about working with him, because you guys have to have that bond,
working
like
with
you've known, yeah, Bradley, like you've known each other for a while. So how was that to develop?
It was quite easy.
it's great.
Because Bradley and we're friends now, off camera, and you know, we hang out still. You know, whether the show goes or doesn't, you know, I would like to have him as a friend in my life. Going forward, and we have a lot of similarities. We love soccer. We played a lot of FIFA. We watch movies together, and it's seeing where we shot scenes in the latter part of the series. The chemistry we have is a lot more, not that it wasn't in the beginning, but it's a lot more fluid and organic. And I'm just really proud of the work we do together. Being friends on camera.
I know you can't give any specifics, but can you just kind of preview generally your character's journey for the rest of the season? Like
he dies in episode 4.
in the pilot, Simone loses her sister in a freak accident, essentially. So she understandably is grieving for a lot of the beginning. Well, maybe for the whole season, but because of the nature of her death, I think she does, all I'll say is she does a lot of searching. She searches for answers.
Yeah. And my character is just trying to keep the Antichrist grounded throughout. Like, he's just, it's kind of like, I think you're being a little bit dramatic calling yourself the Antichrist. Let's just, you know, keep it cool. Let's have a beer. Let's hang out. It's going to be okay. But like I said earlier, there does come a point where he's like, crap, yeah, this is more than I signed up for.
Well, and is he going to have to deal with the idea of I just maybe kill the Antichrist and no more Antichrist?
That doesn't get to that part for me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. Season 2.
Exactly, yeah.
Are there moments on set that are scary?
Yeah, we shot in some really creepy locations, and
yeah,
got spooked a couple times.
We shot in a place that was, I think it was like the Illuminati.
It was like a Masonic temple.
It was a Masonic temple. Yeah,
it was
temple, yeah.
Really,
it was theater in the round, and you're like,
with red carpet,
in spot I'm standing
and
on.
Weird microphones hanging, like they were almost like lanterns, but they were microphones. It was really weird.
They didn't have to change anything.
Yeah, they didn't have to decorate the set. It was nothing. Just creepy,
yeah,
as it was.
It gave me goosebumps, like being in that set, on that set.
Did they tell you anything weird happened there, like in the past?
No, I don't think they wanted to scare us, but we know that. You know, it was like some weird cultish.
They had like these massive portraits of these people, like dating back to the 1800s.
Remember that?
And it was a lot scarier in black and white because as time goes on, they became color, and you're like, ah, this looked like a Sears portrait.
Yeah, that's true.
Was there anything in particular when you were collaborating with Glenn to begin with that he told you about the character that you really latched onto that helped you get
terrorist.
Into him?
Yeah. Yeah, played a lot of terrorists in my career. And for the fact that
really,
he was
I wonder
this,
why.
I don't know. I don't know what you're talking about. No, it's just the fact that for me, it's to play a character who's Middle Eastern and is not involved in terrorism at all,
mm-hmm.
and speaks with my own accent. And really has nothing to do with the fact that he's Middle Eastern or the fact that he's Middle Eastern. Yeah, it was
that's
a
nice.
Breath of fresh air for me.
Yeah.
That's
really nice.
I was like, do you want me to speak Arabic in this? I was like, no, why? I was like, great!
Like,
speak Farsi.
Great, because I don't even know how.
Yeah.
And for you?
What was the question?
Was there anything in particular you latched onto about her?
Well, I like that she was in fashion. I like that she wasn't very clearly defined because it gives you an opportunity as an actor to kind of really play.